la paz de vos. Today we are working on this office block. It's a new day and Abdul got here early and he has patched these walls. They're mostly dry, so he's giving them sand. And we're going to start cutting in and rolling. I said yesterday, this little niche here is one feature wall. And then this red wall here is another feature wall. The feature walls, they're going in hogs bristle half, and all these, the rest of the walls, they're going in hogs bristle quarter. Today we're using Torben's Easy Coat Pro. And as you can see, hogs bristle quarter. Ready to get some paint out, ready to go. And some easy living. There's a few secrets how to cut in straight. First, you need a decent brush in good condition. Second, you need a good cornice line. You need a good line to cut to. You don't really need a steady hand. I don't really have a steady hand. But the main thing is you just be like a robot. Get that good groove, work your way up, and just be a robot. Okay, so it's important after you've patched to put a sealer on. If not, even after two coats, in my experience, you can still see it flashing. They're just using a small roller. Go over any fastened areas. Especially down a wall where there's a lot of light, it'll really stand out. Make sure they're all sanded before you go over them. As you can see, I've started cutting in. And let's get a close up of doing this here.
Go
You want to try and keep that line as long as you can. Long strokes, not short, short ones. So when you dip it in, start underneath, go back, start from back here, go over your work, get on your old line, and then continue it. Main thing is, yeah, starting from back, getting on your own line, and then doing the robot arm. And extending it out as long as you can. Some people just say, oh, you know, I'll cut it in properly, nice and tight on the second coat, but you just do it on the first coat, and you don't really have to do it as good as on the second coat. Helps if you have a good brush and a good line to cut to. So this is the sleeve that we're going to use. It's a Lambswool UniPro sleeve. It's probably too thick to do it on these walls, but we're just going to feather it out nicely and it will be all good anyway. Right here, the silicone was installed. Well, installed. The silicone was put on before the paint, which makes it hard. We'll see how that turns out. Doesn't look too bad. So we don't have much space here, so I'm gonna try and do two coats on this wall and let it dry, and then shift these doors, which are now on eBay, which come from the front, shift them over to here so we can do this, and then do this reception area here. Finish this two coats so we can move that glass over here so we can do the feature wall over there. Bit of a pain, but what are you gonna do? Warm day here in the Gold Coast. It's a big sleeve. Still use a thick sleeve, you just got to make sure you just float it over a little more carefully when the roller is dry. So this is where our feature wall is going, right here where this red wall is. So we bring this wall over and also see we cut along there, so it's thick edge here. So you want to roll these kind of walls like straight away, or else if this dries you'll see that. You'll see that. That's just dust. So yeah, this is where we roll our wall over, so then we cut our feature wall in to this side. So these walls are important to get done first, because we've got another coat to go on that, and it needs to dry, and it needs to be dry enough in the corner for us to cut the feature wall colour in, so keep that in mind if you're doing that. That has to be totally dry before you can cut that feature wall colour in, so don't wait till the end to do that. Like I said, I don't recommend one of these sleeves. Too thick. But you can still use it. You just gotta spread it right out and tip it off properly. One other thing, when you get a new roller, if it's a cheap one, you get a lot of hairs coming out, and you'll look at it and you just see hairs everywhere, and you don't want that. You'll waste a lot of paint, you'll have to strain it. It really takes maybe a few washes, a few goes of a new sleeve for it to work in and be the best it can be.
Not bad. even though these rollers carry more paint, it's a lot slower trying to get it good at the end. Trying to feather it off. Alright, we are nearly done. Looking pretty good in here. Abdul's still doing some shit in the corner there. Yo, wake up. Wake up. Just gotta do outside that door. Actually, the feature walls looks like nearly the same as every other wall. All looking pretty fresh. All done under there. Put the lights out. Put the lights on and the sunglasses on. All looking pretty fresh around this kitchen area. Good through here. Feature wall is done in there. It's the same color. Done down here behind me. And we are doing around these panels, which is not easy. It's all done. Neat as a pin. So we got these stupid panels to do. Look how hard they are. Get your brush in here. Slowly brush it in under here. Not fun. Got like 8 of them to do. I've done a couple. Take about 5 minutes each one. And the sun is setting. Sun is setting over the mountain. I'm talking pro. I'm talking, this ain't no DIY channel. This is the real deal. Alright, thanks for watching this job. Tomorrow, heading north, staying up north. Not gonna be too fun. Working Saturday, working Sunday. Abdul's working Saturday and Sunday, like last week he worked Saturday and Sunday. All work and no play for now. Thanks for watching, see you later. This is what you do to a sleeve. We normally do it with our ceiling rollers. As you can see, there it is there.
And you can go overseas for 2 weeks, come back and just pull it straight out. So you wrap it up airtight and it is good to go.
And you can use the Stanley knife.
Yep, demo the Stanley knife. Well, you're not going to do a very good demo on that, I can tell. You can cut your finger off. But we're going to end it there. See ya, Abdul. We've got a lot of cleaning up to do. You got some paint on your nose too. On the end of your nose.
It's okay.
It's okay. What up, Hamid? Was it Hamid?
Tamir,
that's right. Tamir. You got some fancy looking ones. Yeah. A sick number plate.